I call this story Kice Nelson. I heard it from Buddy McDougall. Buddy McDougall heard it from his cousin, Nelson Adams, so we know it must be true. Buddy said that years ago up in Hebron, where he lives, has lived all his life, there was a chief of police named Barnard. Now, Chief Barnard had responsibility for Hebron, East Hebron, Groton, Bridgewater, pretty much all the little towns clear up to the Plymouth town line. One evening, he got a call from Concord, and the police down in Concord said, "Chief Barnard, be on the lookout. There's some fellas down here. They've robbed a store, they are armed, and we think they're headed in your direction." So Chief Barnard immediately called Nelson Adams, who was his deputy. "Nelson, get over here. I've had a call from Concord." So Nelson rushed over and they took the police cruiser and they drove up to the top of Hoyt Hill. Now from the top of Hoyt Hill, you got a great view. You can see Hebron, East Hebron, Groton, Bridgewater, all the way down through in one direction. And in the other direction, you can see all the way down into beautiful municipal downtown Plymouth. So they sat on the top of Hoyt Hill, pulled back in by a pine tree so it wouldn't be spotted. And they waited, and they waited. And Buddy said that, Nelson said that, they talked about the things that the police chief and the deputy might talk about. He didn't know what they were exactly, but they chatted and they waited, and it got later and later and darker, wee hours of the morning, when they spotted way down the road two little pinpricks of light coming in their direction. Chief Barnard says, "Nelson, that must be them. Who else would be on the road this time of the night?" And those two pinpricks of light got brighter and brighter, and they could hear the revving of the engine. And here comes those two bad fellas from Concord, robbed a store, armed and dangerous. And Nelson says to Chief Barnard, "Chief, what are we going to do now?" And Chief Barnard says, "Kice, Nelson, we set right here another 5 minutes, they'll be in Plymouth."